from the first day he came over, he was a very polite, mannerly, well brought up young child or man, boy, whatever. I suppose he's a young man now, but as a boy, as a child, he was like, well, he was a child because I think he was probably 12 or 13 when he came over here, probably first. But he was a very well brought up, mannerly young lad that wanted to learn, you know, and I think when they have that, they've always got a chance, you know.
Dylan originally came down here to ride out on a few weekends, I think, when he was pony racing. About a couple of years ago now, and he'd come and ride out on weekend, and then he came for a couple of weeks on his summer holidays. Dylan was very lucky to strike up a good partnership with Lawrence, the owner of Baron Samedi. He had previously rode a few winners on a nice horse called Grandmaster Flash, and so he got to keep the ride on that horse and rode him in Navan in a group race and gave him a very good ride to win. And he obviously rode the horse later in the season in the Ledger and in Ascot. Those days, I'm sure, have been fantastic experience for Dylan. And absolutely, he's more than capable of competing at that level.
The Emperor of the Sun is trying to come back at them. It's Baron Samedi just in front, leads by fine margins, going to the line. Baron Samedi, six in a row, wins the Vintage Cup for Dylan Brown McMonagall, Master of Reality, Emperor of the Sun, Santiago and Stratum.
I think my wife had seen it on YouTube or had seen it something about this little lad from Donegal or whatever that had, was mad into pony racing, and watched the clip and he had decided to, I think, make contact with him and then eventually invite him over. And, you know, I kind of was thinking I had better things to be doing, to be honest. And she said, could you imagine if John Frankham or Richard Dunwoody or someone had of, you know, invited you over when you were that age, you know, what, you know, how much you'd have enjoyed it or not. And I thought, okay, then, well, maybe it's the right thing to do. But I have been very impressed with Dylan. I've been very impressed that you know that he's got to where he's got to in a short space of time. It's important for him now that he tries to improve on that and tries to get better. But as I said, he's very lucky. He seems to have had a very good upbringing. He seems to have a very, you know, he's a very good family, and he's been very well brought up. And I'm sure he'll continue to make them all very proud. You know, I look back at it, I look at him now and think how lucky a position that he's in now, that he's in. You know, I'd love to be going back to try and I'd give it all back to go back to his stage in life and be starting off again, you know. And he's got a great opportunity to make a very good career for himself. Well, hopefully he can make a great career for himself. That all comes down to him in the end, you know. It depends how dedicated you are, how much you want it, and how far you're prepared to go.
To be champion apprentice in Ireland is a huge achievement. And there's so many good young riders coming on the scene every year who have good support from good trainers and owners, and it's a huge achievement to be champion apprentice in Ireland.